Hey, my name's Sean. Welcome to Echoes in Eternity Bourbon. First off, I'd like to say Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there. I tell you what, you ladies do a fantastic job. Appreciate everything you do. Special thanks to my wife, Michelle Ruckman, and my ex-wife, you know, Cassandra Neal, and my daughter with my two grandsons. She's doing a fantastic job with Dallas and Colton. You ladies make all the difference in the world. You have such huge impact, and I truly love and appreciate y'all. Thank you. Today, something special. I don't know if it's serendipitous that it happened to show up on Mother's Day, but ran into a unique opportunity. I have a bottle of George T. Stagg 2019. And then I ran into the opportunity to say, hey, this person that I'd got that from before had said, I've got a second bottle if you're interested. And I thought, man, that's awesome. Because you know how sometimes it's hard to open one of those bottles that you don't know if you're ever going to see again. And you're like, huh, if I have two, what kind of fun can we have there? So, gentleman by the name of Paul, I've done some trading with him in the past. Sometimes, you know, bottles, sometimes courtesy, make sure things are evened up. But very knowledgeable guy. Been able to trade some samples with him as well. Absolutely love dealing with him. But he's the one that brought this to me. Saw a bottle that I had that was extra and said, are you interested in this? So we worked out a trade. Very excited about this. But what does this mean not only for me, but what does it mean for, of course, some of my friends, but also potential for someone that enjoys this channel? So I want to go ahead and give my review of the George T. Stagg 2019, and then talk a little bit about, you know, what the future may hold for that. But George T. Stagg 2019, let's see what we got. For those that don't know, and I'm sure most that watch this channel do, George T. Stagg is one of the annual BTACs that come out from the Buffalo Trace line. So it's a Buffalo Trace antique collection. So these are something that are highly sought after in the bourbon community, something that people like to hunt. I'm still trying to fill out my collection. I've got 3 of 5 bottles, but I'm still working it. But it happens to be ironic that now I've got a fourth bottle, but it's a backup of the exact same year. So I know exactly what juice that I have in that other bottle. So let's give it a nose and see what we got. I get chocolate. I'm getting cinnamon. I'm getting oak on this. I'm getting caramel. I'm getting vanilla. I mean, this thing, it's got a lot of great nose on this. I'm really, really enjoying the nose on this. I think I did a short that came out earlier today. When I first cracked this and smelled the cork, I'm like, golly, even the cork. I mean, I gnaw on the cork, it smelled so good. So I was excited about that. Excellent nose on this. Getting some leather, tobacco. I mean, you're getting all the hitters, heavy hitters from what a bourbon should be on the nose on this. The chocolate is something interesting in there. The cinnamon, you know, I'm getting some cinnamon in there. So that's something that may be just a little bit different than most of your standard bourbons, but very interested to see what it's like on the palate now. Great mouthfeel, getting some pepper, getting your nice Kentucky hug. This isn't as high a proof as some of the other George T. Stags, but I think it's running at what, 119 proof? I'm sorry, 116.9 proof on this. But you get a nice flavor on the back. You're getting the oak on the back. getting the chocolate, getting the cinnamon. I'm getting more of a lighter caramel on this, not a heavy, heavy caramel, but a lighter caramel. Still that really good pepper on the tongue. Very, very nice finish on this. This is a longer finish on this. I'm definitely enjoying that. Man, I'm still getting a little even tingle on my lips. I really, really like this bourbon. I know maybe compared to some other stags, this is a little bit different, but I still think it's an outstanding pour. Is it very pricey on the secondary? Abso-freaking-lutely. You know, I think that you really need to look at yourself if you're going to purchase a bottle like this secondary. If you can find it, you know, which you'll never find unless you get in the lottery hit or something like that at MSRP, or unless you're part of a points club or something like that. This is still finishing. This is outstanding. A little bit of dryness too on the back. But if you find it in a trade, I think that it's a neat bottle to have. It's a neat bottle that you can share with friends or use it even for something else potentially in trade. Definitely enjoying this. And the best part of bourbon is you want to be able to share this. You know, you want to be able to let some of the other people experience some of the things that you have too. You know, so I've got a few steadies that when I open something that's really, really good, they're going to get a sample. One of these today is actually going to be my brother-in-law. We're going to meet him tonight with my sister-in-law. Kind of a surprise Mother's Day dinner, you know, for her. She doesn't realize that, she doesn't realize that her daughter is actually going to be there today. And this video will come out, of course, after we're going to have this meeting and dinner tonight. So she won't know anything about it. So it'll be a nice, nice surprise. But I've been building, as you see, a little bit of a sample pack here. I got another sample pack I got out yesterday. But this will be part of something for my brother-in-law. I also have a couple other people that'll be getting samples of this. My son-in-law, of course, will get a sample of this. I've got a couple of friends. I've got someone that I've been trading some amazing samples with. Thank you, Terrence. He'll be getting a sample of this. And so I'm looking forward to that. But I also would like to maybe, you know, get a random sample out to someone so they can have an experience to try some of this as well. Looking forward to that. It'll be an Easter egg type of thing. You have to find the Easter egg. If you find the Easter egg, say the correct phrase, you're continental U.S., you're over 21. If you win that, you'll get a sample of George T. Stagg. I do 2-ounce samples. That way, if you want to split it up or you just want to have a nice time to explore it, you'll have that opportunity. Also later today, I'm going to be doing a kind of a tribute to a friend that had passed. I'll be hanging out with my buddy Patrick Kite. He goes by the tag Actor by Night, but with a K in front of it. He does some videos and stuff, but there's a friend of ours that had passed away, and he had left a scorpion bottle that, you know, it's not a bourbon. It'll be something a little bit different, but we're going to add this tribute to this video as well, just to, you know, let his friends and family know that we still think about him. He's a great guy. But that'll be something a little bit different. Plus, I'm going to add some videos of you know, how I toured the area this week. I was able to pick up some neat bottles. I may even take a picture of all the bottles that I got this week. Of course, do not tell my wife. Some great bottles this week. Every month I say, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get any bottles. And I'm not even through with this month. We're only mid-month. And I'm thinking, number one, how am I going to be able to continue at this pace? And number two, I don't know if I'm ever going to find bottles like some of these again, but very excited about that. But I hope you all have an amazing day. I hope you're treating your mothers right. If you're a mother, I hope that you're having a fantastic day. We should treat you like queens every day. But I'm hoping today is just a little extra something on your crown. Thank you for all you do. You all have an amazing day. All right. Good afternoon, everybody. I mentioned earlier that we were going to have a remembrance pour for a friend, Josh. Crown XR is a
is now a whiskey you can no longer get. Thought this was a great appropriate pour for Josh. We'll tell a little bit about it when we get outside, but my friend Patrick prefers a shot and I like to sip a little bit, but we're gonna run it through this aerator here. Get some in here. Get it aerated into his shot glass. All right, I'm gonna do one for myself and give a little review on this at the same time and give some thoughts on Josh. Yes, it's definitely, certainly missed. All right, we're gonna bring this outside and give some thoughts.
All right, so Josh's dear friend was also bartender. I could say I had the privilege to know him as a friend. I know Patrick was a whole lot closer, but had the opportunity to play some disc golf with him and his brother. Awesome dude, time in the military, veteran. Can't say enough good things about him. Sorry that he's not here with us anymore. So on this Crown XR, you get some caramel up front, very light. You get smoke, but it's very, very mellow. Vanilla, just it smells like summer. Let's give it a taste, see what we have. That is an incredible mouthfeel. Very smooth. It's not at all where you get a lot of alcohol burn. Very easy to drink. You're getting the caramels, you're getting the vanillas on the back. Amazing pour for a person that's no longer with us, but we're keeping you and your family in prayer, and we'll see you again someday, brother.
Yep, Sean said everything that I was gonna say. We miss Josh. Great guy, great sense of humor. Think about him often. Like he said, the disc golf, the fun, you just never knew what was going to happen with him, especially on the 4th of July. When he got going. Just a great guy. We miss him, so that's why we're going to drink some of this Crown XR.
All right, cheers, brother.
Cheers to you, Jay. Josh. Smooth. I taste whiskey.
I taste smooth caramel and vanilla. Y'all have a great day. Lafayette Beverage hanging out at LaGrange Lake. Let's see what we got inside there. Out of here, Wild Bills. Let's see what we could find today. They've had some nice things at nice prices lately. Let's see if we can find something new inside. Hanging out at Maple Party Shop. Let's see what we got inside today.
Did Danny text you?
No, I was in here talking to Matt earlier this week about it, and Ian was here. That's the one, other one I'm looking for. Yes, ma'am, it is. Thank you.
Come on.
Ready?
I'm still wandering.
I'm always ready for you.
Am I
going to
have to pay to check in those?
Yes. So we got ball games all weekend, or are we done?
The weather depending. We're supposed to be out this night. I don't know.
Let's see. Kind of looks like it might rain.
It's supposed to start again.
All right, so if you've made it this far into the video and you're a subscriber and you want to get some of the George T. Stagg 19, in the comments, put cheers, C-H-E-E-R-S. Y'all have an amazing day. Whiskey shop's been good to me lately. Let's see what they got inside. Still got some 13 Colony in here. That sour mash is always awesome. Hey, how you doing today? There you go. Yeah. Amen to that. What's that?
It's a scotch.
Oh.
Bowman Irish.
Beverage. I haven't had much luck out here, but let's see if we got something on the inside. All right, hanging out the bottle. Let's see if you got something good inside. This is store officer, call my mister.